today we have Mr. Rajesh Sharma. He is the faculty at KK Modi University. Good morning to you, sir.
Morning.
My first question to you is that being the faculty of KK Modi University, what are your roles and responsibilities towards the student as well as the university there?
As a faculty of KK Modi University, I have the duties like conducting training for the students and preparing them for the future based on the technologies, like I'm working on data science, artificial intelligence, cybersecurity, and all these things. I have to prepare the student for their future. And along with that, I am conducting exams also, and assignments I'm preparing for them. And as well as we are going for upgrading their skills level and conducting seminars for them on latest technologies, what are latest technologies in the market that we have, and keep on conducting seminars and conducting seminars for my colleagues also even. So that's what is my role and responsibilities at KK Modi.
Okay. So you are completely into IT side of the college. About whether it is BTEC, CSE, so they have majors in cybersecurity and artificial intelligence.
Yeah. So BBA students. Some BBA students are also there. They attended the session for data science, and there are students of data science students are all already there, and cybersecurity students are also there who attended my sessions for database management, and they are. We are just preparing them for the future, and you know that whatever is happening nowadays, so we are just filling the gap between the industry and the academics.
That is great. So my next question to you is, when you came to this college, what was your vision and what was your understanding before joining KKMU, what you wanted to achieve for this institute and for the students?
Yeah, before joining the KK Modi, I'm just working with the corporate industry, and I'm seeing a lot of gap between the corporate industry and the academics, which is happening in the college nowadays. Maybe you have also faced the scenario that you have gone to some company, and the company is claiming that these developers are not directly cannot be put into the projects.
Yes,
and that knowledge level gap is always there between the industry and the academics. So I've just taken initiative. So why not? I'll just go to the colleges and start teaching the students these corporate things, so that the students are already knowledgeable about the industry standards, how the industry works, what kind of project they are working, the coding standard they are following, what practices they are following. So that all can be taught to these students. So when they are going from their colleges to the industry, so these students are already prepared and acquainted with all these tools. So that's why I've just gone to these colleges and started doing this thing. So for that, I started going to as a guest lecturer to some of the colleges and started conducting some training and then talking to the students also sometimes. So in nearby places, I'm just talking to the students and giving them the guidance. Okay, this how you can prepare yourself. In my family also, a lot of kids are there. So they are also going to the next year to the colleges. So I'm guiding them also that how to prepare for the industry.
Yes, it is very much required to be prepared for the industry.
Yeah.
Even I am a graduate, and I find a lag between what I studied in digital marketing college and how the digital marketing works at a college when you are a company.
Yeah, because you are learning at the theoretical aspect in the colleges, and moreover, the lecturers are not exposed to the practical knowledge of the subject. And due to that gap, so student is suffering. Because when student is going to the industry, then student will be just like in a fix-up that how to deal with these things now, how to deal with these tools, because they got the live tools over there in front of them. How to utilize those tools is there's a lot of gap you will find over there. So when you came to the industry, then only you came to know that what is happening and how these tools are working, and what are the pros and cons of these two using these tools. So there you find several tools are there. So then you will judge which is a good tool for doing this task or achieving your task.
So I just wanted to know how do you do these trainings and how do you bring in the practical approach towards subjects and make them industry ready? Are there any tools and technology that are used in the company, same are used in KK Modi University?
See, these tools are almost similar, which students are already using. The only thing is they need to know is how practically they can be utilized those tools in their corporate environment, how these organizations are utilizing those tools. So the only way of using them is totally different in that corporate industry. Say, for example, if I'll take an example of building an application. So when the users are building the application, when the students are building the application, what they are doing is they are writing the entire code of user interface. The application is actually divided in the industry. It's a layered architecture which they follow. If I'll give an example. So industry follows a layered architecture, which is generally N-tier layer and N-layer architecture. So even what students are doing when they are developing the application in their colleges, they are developing a single layer application, and in that they embed everything as a part of that application. And when somebody asks them, okay, do the optimization of this, now they can't do it. And sometimes they copy the code from Google also. And that is also creating a hell of trouble for the students. Because they unknowingly they copies that code without understanding the code, they copies that code and put that code into their application. And when lecturer asks them, okay, the Viva questions will come, okay, how you'll optimize this part, then they lost in that. So to fill up these gaps and to all these things, what I do is I'll create take a shot of project within the classroom itself. So when this project is going on, when the classroom study is going on, they are building the project actually in the classroom itself. So what we do is we started implementing everything into the project. So by the time my session will be over, means 10 days, 15 days session will be over with these people. So what happens is they are already acquainted with all the tools required for developing industry-based applications. So when they are doing their project, so they do the project exactly the same way what they did in the classroom actually. So this made them industry ready.
Exactly.
And even in some colleges, I have made the trainings like Allahabad University. I've conducted training with the Apex College, Jaipur, and I'm conducting in the KK Modi University itself. And so there, what happened is the students are directly placed into the organizations and they don't need the trainings actually further.
Okay. That is great. My next question is with over 23 plus years of experience, what is the best advice you can give to the upcoming generations that are aspiring to be technocrats or join big IT companies out there?
Yeah, the big inspiring thing over here is that anybody comes to an IT industry, that you have to upgrade your knowledge every time. A continuous upgradation of the knowledge is required in this field. If you will not upgrade your knowledge, industry will throw you out. So that's why my advice to everybody, that please start upgrading your knowledge, keep on upgrading your knowledge. Even though you are in industry, you are already having a good job in your hand, maybe you are a senior or maybe you are a junior, but still keep on acquiring the knowledge. Keep on upgrading your knowledge, because in IT, you'll see every 3 months, a new set of technologies will be launched. IT is so fast, it's so vast also.
I just wanted to know, how do you tend to establish a healthy relationship environment in the class as well as in the college with other peer faculties and also the students of KK Modi?
Okay. For keeping a healthy environment, first of all, I'll not start my session straight away with my topic actually. So I'll take some motivating story in the classroom itself or whatever is happening in a day in the morning time. So I'm just informing the kids, okay, let's start with that. And then I'm talking to that, what are good and bads they have seen in that. So that the people will come out, first of all, their that mind blockage actually. Because first, you know that in a session, the first 15, 20 minutes, people are not in the classroom at all. So for managing that environment, you need to interact with the people in such a way that, okay, they will first come to the classroom with their mind actually, which is required to be present in the class. And then I'll make some quizzes in the classroom so that the students will be more interactive with me. And I'll keep on asking them the question. If they feel hesitant, so I'll ask the question to the student always, who feel more hesitant in the classroom, so that the student will come out and bring his ability to ask the question. Because that is also important for a student. Asking the question to the trainer is also important, because verification of the knowledge is also required. Because I have seen that some of the lecturers are delivering the knowledge, and when they delivered it, some of the points maybe gone wrong. So the student can also challenge that. Student can learn about it and can challenge the classroom. Okay, you told these things are wrong, or maybe these things can be done in some other way. So the students can also come up with their ideas, and I'll most welcome those ideas with the student, because in that way the students are learning. So that is called learning. It means that I feel that it's a learning. My point of view. Maybe some people won't be agree with me, but I'll say that's a two-way learning is happening, because I'm also learning from my students actually. Because when they presenting the different way of implementing a technology or implementing some good ideas, so they are most welcome in the classroom.
Yes. And today the students are very, very creative, mainly when a teacher teaches them, and they find another way of implementing the same thing. So that should be quite welcomed in the class, and teachers should not be offended, and they should take it like teaching for themselves also.
Yeah, so, because I don't want the student to be like mugging up everything.
Exactly.
So that mugging is creating a hell of trouble for the students actually.
Yes. So my next question is, what are some of the biggest challenges you see for both for the IT industry in general and for KK Modi University specifically?
Yeah, this is the biggest challenge is nowadays. Yesterday, I'm just seeing a lot of people in the news. They are saying that if you've heard in the news that COVID application is not multilingual, and people are facing challenges in registering themselves. So our media is also creating this problem that they are delivering this knowledge. The application is already multilingual. Now, what they mean by multilingual, they are not specific to it now. See, maybe the interface is not too much interactive, but the application is already multilingual and people are discussing that only. So you will see the awareness gap is there. So this awareness gap is everywhere, whether it is IT industry or it is with the college also, related to the college also. So what I'll do, what I feel is, my personal feeling is that, or when I've discussed with some of the people also, they also feel that this gap is always there. So first of all, create an awareness about just like what college is doing. So nowadays you are seeing a lot of scenarios that a lot of cheating and frauds are happening. And the college, you have seen our college is in the rural area. It's not in just like a Delhi. We have just gone to Durg. So why we have gone to Durg? Main reason for going to that remote place is because some people even haven't heard the name of the place, even though it's a very important place, historical place in India. So Durg, why we have just gone? So that we can connect the rural with the urban areas. And even you will feel the urban people are having not much knowledge. They are lacking that knowledge which is required. So we are trying to fill up that gap actually. So that filling up that gap is the most biggest challenge of the industry, as well as the IT, as well as the KK Modi College or anybody else.
Exactly. Yes. So so how do you help students to cope up with the competition being so high outside the world? Because the IT industries are limited and the people passing out from BTech, CSIT or these branches is huge. So unemployment rate is very high. So how do you help students to cope up with that?
Yeah, it's a very important thing nowadays. What is happening is our competition is a lot. And moreover, the IT has came to the level of stagnation. You've seen the limited number of jobs are available in the market, and a more number of people are coming to this industry. So my advice to what I'm doing is with my students is that I'm making them to practice a lot with this thing. Along with the practice, I'm suggesting them to teach that particular subject to somebody also, so that they are ready with those topics. And whenever they are having some doubts and all, so they get cleared when they are teaching somebody. So teach it to at least 2-3 of your colleagues in that way. So I'm just suggesting the group study along with that, and try to implement all the theoretical aspect as a practical. Try to build an application. And when you are building that application, try to get this application verified by somebody in the industry, so that that person, industry guy, can tell them, okay, where they lack and what they are lacking over there. So that's what I'm doing with my student, and I'm telling them, okay, it's not me only that is going to validate it. So one of my colleagues also, I'm sending that application to the validation, so that if anywhere they are lacking, maybe I'm not seeing all the points. That also is a human tendency. So I'm suggesting that to means that application got validated from different sources, and then that will be delivered finally. So in that way, I'm helping my students that they will be ready for the industry, ready to face these challenges. And when these people are coming up with these kind of things, so they are already ready for the interview. They are ready for all type of sort of question of the interview, and then they get very fast selected in the industry.
Exactly. So my last question, and I was very curious about it. So you had a very, very prosperous career in corporate world. So what motivated you to join an education institute to start teaching students? So was it your love for teaching, or did you see any opportunity out there in education industry?
Okay. How I came to this industry is just like when I started my career, I started as a data entry operator. I'll tell you, frankly speaking, I started as a data entry operator and used to get a salary like $2,500 on that time, 23 years back. So when I started, when I met one of my colleague's brother, and he told us, okay, what do you know about the IT? What do you know about the technology? And on that day, he asked a lot of questions to us, but we are not able to even answer a single question on that day. So feeling very insulted and very dejected on that day. And now I've just thought of, okay, doing something now, because now I have to do something. And on that time, you won't believe that I'm having a salary like from 20,000 to 2,500 to like 10,000 salary on that time. And I left my job immediately after knowing all these things. And I started learning. So I thought I should be a programmer now. But by that time, I've got ready. So what happened is, there is a recession, huge recession in the IT in the year 2000, I'm talking about. So there is a huge recession in the IT, and I've gone to the industry on that time. So a bad phase is going on, and not getting the job of a developer. So what happened is, somebody suggested me, why not you become a trainer? So I became a trainer on that time. So trainer, not my passion, but I become by means by choice, no choices there. So I became a trainer. Okay. But when I joined as a trainer, so my first student, you won't believe that, says it's a professor of the university. So I got motivated from that professor and adopt this career, adopt my teaching as my passion now. I developed passion towards it now. So now I'm very passionate about teaching, and it becomes my passion that, okay, I'll just teach the people. I enlighten other people also about this, about the technology, how it's going to work, and how they can prepare their life for the future. So this is how that I've just gone to the teaching, and it becomes my passion now. And now I'm very passionate about the teaching, and it's become my, not only as a career opportunity, so it becomes I'm very passionate about it, and telling the students and guiding the students, and I'm going to the colleges also as a guest lecturer, conducting a lot of seminars for the colleges. So I've just gone to a lot of girls' colleges and boys' colleges, even co-ed colleges also. I'm just going, and even some schools also. I'm guiding the students also in my nearby areas. And wherever I meet the people in the train or in buses, so I just keep on, not even the by air when I'm flying. So I'm talking to the people. So I'm just motivating them about the education, because you know that everywhere, because everything starts with education.
Exactly.
And it stands there only.
Yeah, that is so great. So that's all, sir, from our side, and we thank you for taking your time in early morning and coming up here. So
it's a normal time. It's not early. Early will be like 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yes, sir. So thank you so much, sir, for that.